Good morning everyone, I'm Prasad Arhav. Today I'll be presenting my work on evaluation of erosion inside abrasive watershed cutting nozzle by six-way coupling of discrete element methods, computational fluid dynamics, and finite element methods using Precise. The general outline of my presentation is as follows. First, we will look at the problem statement and the goals. Then we'll see how we achieve the six-way coupling. Then we'll see some results for the nozzle. I will update you on the work in progress. And lastly, we'll see. I'll present some future work. Let's see the first part, the problem statement and goals. Abrasive water jet cutting nozzle has a lot of advantages over its counterparts, but I'm not going to talk about that here today. As the name suggests, abrasive water jet cutting nozzle uses high speed water jet entrained with abrasive particles for cutting. But unfortunately, the nozzle itself is often the first target of these particles, which causes erosion inside the nozzle. The erosion inside the nozzle is very difficult to capture through experimentation due to the hostile environment inside the nozzle, so it makes it desirable to have simulations. Up until now, only erosion concentration zones have been identified through simple DEM and CFD coupling. The erosion is estimated through the number of impacts over time, but very crucial factors causing erosion, that is the particle velocity and the angle of attack, are ignored, thus giving an incomplete picture of the erosion phenomenon. I plan to evaluate the erosion through DEM, CFD and FEM coupling. By having a full coupling, I plan to include all these factors in the evaluation of erosion. Now we'll see some how we achieve the six-way coupling. I think everyone who has visited the Precise website is already familiar with this image. You also know that Calculix and OpenFOAM adapters are already available from Precise. Here we use XTM, an in-house solver which, as the name suggests, uses discrete element method which is used for solving particle motion to have the six-way coupling. Just a quick note, OpenFOAM will appear as OF and Calculix as CCX henceforth. In the default Precise FSI two-way tutorial, we have an exchange of forces coming from OpenFOAM, which is pressure over the area, which Calculix uses as a boundary condition and solves for displacement. And Calculix sends back the displacement to OpenFOAM, and this way we achieve two-way coupling. Here, to extend the two-way case to six-way case, we add XTM, which solves for the particle motion. For the XTM coupling, Precise do not see the particles. Instead, XTM does the work of converting the DEM objects, which is particles and walls, into mesh or data that is that can be dealt with by Precise. Like in this case, we have volume fields such as porosity and surface fields such as surface forces. For the coupling between XTM and Calculix, it is straightforward. Like I explained before, for two-way OpenFOAM and Calculix coupling, XTM gives the forces to Calculix, and Calculix solves for displacements and gives back the displacement to XTM. As of now, we don't have to modify the Calculix adapter to have this coupling. For the coupling between XTM and OpenFOAM, it's a bit more complicated and we need some modifications. So for XTM, computes the porosity and sends it as a volume field to OpenFOAM. The particles are modeled in fluid as porosity, which is explicit drag injected through FE options. Then XTM receives volume field fluid velocity, and along with some hard-coded fluid properties, it computes the drag and buoyancy acting on the particle, and it solves for the particle motion. But as you might have guessed, that having hard-coded fluid properties is not really practical. So I have added the fluid property fields required by the XTM, such as density, viscosity, In case of multi-phase flow, we also need a gradient of pressure, and in the future we'll be also using the gradient of alpha, which is the interface variable. I have also changed the way XTM computes the drag and buoyancy acting on the particles depending on the type of solver used on the open foam side, which is single phase or multi-phase, incompressible or compressible. For multi-phase flow, the porosity is not enough to model the particles in the fluid, so I have to introduce an explicit and implicit drag source term, which are computed by XTM and then transferred as volume fields, omega, and acceleration, and in turn which are also injected through FE options. Now we'll see the test case setup for six-way coupling. We start from the perpendicular flap case setup provided for the two-way open foam and calculix coupling. The open foam and calculix setup stays the same. We have the fluid entering from the left, solvent open foam. We have the deformable flap, solvent calculix, and we have particles solvent XTM. So here we have light particles entering from the bottom, and we have heavy particles entering from the top. Before seeing some results, some of you who might have attended the first precise workshop would have already seen the results presented by my colleague Albin Rousseau, but at the time he was using Deal 2 instead of Calculix. So like in the two-way case, the flap deforms due to the fluid flow as well as due to the particles. In this case, as expected, the heavy particles fall due to gravity and light particles float up due to buoyancy. Also, we can see that the particles are pushed in the direction of the flow. Since this is an incompressible single-phase fluid flow, we don't really use the new implementations. For this, here I use a compressible solver. Hence, we have a non-uniform density and viscosity distribution in the domain. Same goes for the pressure and the gradient of the pressure. So we need this information for drag and buoyancy forces acting on the particles. This test case shows that the successful outcome of the new implementations done in the XTM and open foam adapters. Due to the turbulent flow, it is also interesting to see that some of the particles are caught in the vortices. Even though they are light, they don't just float away. We see the fluid forces acting on them. And if you look at the time, the total time of the simulation, it's a bit short because I could not get the simulation to run stably for a longer duration. And well, that is one of the things I plan to learn and understand better in this workshop. Now, let's talk about modifications required for the multi-phase flow in open foam adapter. When I was working on these modifications sometime last year, the default open foam adapter did not support FSI for multi-phase solver, but I think the current version should support multi-phase flow. It would be great if a precise team member clarifies this if anyone has a doubt. I made the necessary modifications in the precise open foam adapter. The solver I use is Interfoam, which is incompressible. But if somebody were to use compressible Interfoam, it should definitely work with the default open foam solver. But in my case, for the nozzle application, I use an incompressible interfoam solver. For the test case, I again start from the perpendicular flap case, but this time we have a small water column. Then we'll first see the result for this test case, and then we'll have a results for test case with the porosity region added. So here the fluid and the solid geometry are same as the perpendicular flap case tutorial provided. The only difference is we use inlet boundary as a wall so that the water does not fall out of the domain. In this setup we have water in red and air in blue, and finally in the middle we have the deformable flap, which is solved by Calculix. Here we clearly see the deformations in the flap when the water column crashes on it, and we also see the air is disturbed through the velocity vectors, which are plotted on the results. So we can say that okay, now the multiphase FSI coupling is working well. Moving on to the next stage. So here we also add the porosity, so that we test that the porosity is working well with the multiphase simulations. So I set the porosity region using set fields, and for having this for injecting the drag term, we need the different fluid density and viscosities acting, so we cannot just have constants like in a single phase solver. So we also test out the new implementations in the OpenFOAM adapter. Here we can compare the results for a case with and without a porosity region. We first see the water column crashing under the influence of gravity. We can see the porosity region induces drag as expected. It is especially clear when we see the velocity vector field. And we also see that the water is caught in the porous region a bit before falling back down again like a sponge. And just to make it clear, the results clear, I'll show the results again with the velocity fields. Now we'll see some couple simulation results for the nozzle, but before we can do that, we first need to understand the setup of the simulation. So here the fluid geometry and the mesh were already available from the work of Gabriel Bozzetti and Bernard Peters. We have the water jet entering at high velocity from this inlet here. Then in the case of six-way coupling, the green patch will be the inlet for the abrasive particles, but in the case of two-way coupling, we'll be injecting it from the face where we have the inlet of water jet. Finally, we see the nozzle solid part geometry, which I modeled and meshed in Salome. I will just briefly describe the size of meshes being used to give the scope or the size of the simulations we are running. So XTM uses STL file to exchange forces and displacements. It has around 50,000 elements. The XTM domain itself has 400,000 elements, but it does not translate into a huge domain. The number of particles injected govern the simulation time as well. The nozzle solid part has around 320,000 tetrahedral elements, and the fluid part has around 500,000 hexahedral elements. Before we have a six-way simulation of the nozzle, two-way couple simulation between each solver is to be tested to see if the physics works properly. So first we see the results for two-way coupling between OpenFOAM and Calculix. Here we see just the results for the CFD part of the nozzle. We have just sliced the result in ParaView. So in this case, I did not particularly include the solid part here because we don't see much deformations in the nozzle material since it is steel. On the contrary, the fluid results are quite interesting as they are driving mechanism for AWJC nozzle. So at the bottom, you see the water jet traveling along the length of the nozzle. As the water jet enters the focusing tube, which is the narrow cylinder long tube, it creates a negative pressure or vacuum. The negative pressure then in turn drives the fluid flow from the hopper, which is the inclined part on the top, and that is where ideally the particles enter from, and they are sucked by this fluid flow into the mixing chamber, which is the converging part of the nozzle, but this will be in the six-way coupling. So this is just to establish that the fluid flow inside is working well. Here we just see the water jet entering in the nozzle. It's the same simulation but in a 3D perspective, and it is more interesting to see now the aeroglyphs for velocity vector velocity inside the hopper as the water jet goes to the focusing tube. It creates a negative pressure, and then we can see that the flow is established from the top of the hopper. Now we'll see some results for two-way coupling between XTEM and Calculix. Although this is well established for the flap, here it needs to be tested since we now have a complex geometry. Here, since there is no water jet to drive the particles are injected with an initial velocity of 10 meters per second and bombarded inside the nozzle. To test out the physics, in this case, the solid nozzle is made out of rubber-like material to show the effects of the particle impacts. The actual nozzle, as I said before, will be made out of steel, and the average impact velocity of the particles is 104 meters per second. But in any case, we can see that the impact forces are transferred properly to the complex geometry, and we can see the minute deformations where the particles are impacting. Here we see the same results as the last slide, but with some deformations seen as color contours. We also see the normal forces applied by the particles. This data is now available through after the coupled simulation, so I plan to post-process this data and use it for the erosion calculations. Now, you might be expecting the results for two-way coupling between XTEM and open foam for the nozzle right about now, but currently it is a work in progress. So let's see what else do we have work in progress. So currently I'm working on injecting the new drag source terms through FE options and see that everything works properly and we have a physically correct simulations. Once I do that successfully, I can have the DEM and CFD coupling, which will allow me to have the two-way coupling with the water jet and particles. I also plan to use the summation action on the forces coming from open foam and XTEM. Previously, my colleagues were using DEAL2 for FEM part, and they had modified the DEAL2 adapter for summing up the forces coming from open foam and XTEM. For post-processing the results, that is making some calculations. In my view, ParaView is perfect. If I want to do such post-processing on the results obtained from Calculix, I need to convert the FRD to a proper format, for which I use a open source Python script. But it is not perfect if you have a very large result file, so it needs to be modified so that it can handle a very large result file. Now let's see some future work. I plan to write a Python script for ParaWave, which will decompose the impact forces for the particles and then use this decomposed impact forces, force vectors, and then particle velocities for calculations of erosion. I have already activated the frequency module in Calculix used and I already have the natural frequency for the nozzle under different static conditions. Next, I plan to use particle impacts as the boundary condition and then compute forced vibrations. In the long run, we want to have a generalized XTEM adapter where we want to process all the calculations on XTEM side and only transfer the final source term to be injected into the fluid solver. I also plan to generalize the drag law calculations. Currently, only one law, a drag law, is hard coded. XTEM has an implementation of 8 drag laws, and so we can choose from them depending on the conditions of the simulation. So, I want to include that as well. And in the longer run, it is planned to use the 6-way coupling where the CFD for CFD. Open foam will be replaced by ANSYS. I would like to take this opportunity to thank the Precise team for their support so far, and I thank you for your attention.